In my life so far, I've learned to change what I can, to accept what I can't change, and to forget what I can't bear. So I found that in life we're always drawn towards two positive extremes. We're drawn towards excitement and contentment. Excitement is the active part of life that makes us jump out of bed and rush to that steaming cup of coffee or to the one we love, or to a plane that's traveling around the world. And contentment is quieter, it's more passive. Contentment is found in small comforts, like friendship, or the satisfaction of a good day's work, or the peace of food, or sleep, or storytelling, or singing, or just sitting and thinking best, or a mixture of them all. I've also noticed that, wrong as he often was, Aristotle hit upon a winning idea in his concept of a golden mean. Now, a golden mean is like a balance between two extremes, and this is what we're finding here. Because while it would be delightful to only need the simple comfort of the Shire or the excitement of being in love, neither of them really last very long at a stretch, which is unfortunate. So you need to have both so you can go between the two or find somewhere in between. Although to be honest, given the choice between excited and contented love, I'm sure I would choose excitement, and I'm sure most people would as well. Now I should tell you, excitement isn't what a Catholic Church would condemn as sinful, because it isn't always carnal or gluttonous, even in excess. It can be as simple as running as fast as you can through pouring rain, or going to the other side of the world to see what you love. And equally, contentment, which, as I said, is the quieter side, it isn't austere or Spartan. Because if you think about the Hobbit tradition of having 6 meals a day when they can, that would fit into contentment because it's quiet. I mean, in some ways, you could say gluttonous, but it's a very quiet way of living. So that's contentment. And that would fit just as much as doing nothing but feeling very connected. The two are both very, the two both work because they're very quiet. So the important distinction that I should clarify is that one is active and one is passive. Now, returning to the question of balance, how do you see in the musical Fame? If you haven't, watch it. I'm performing it, and in my last video, I put some links to it. I put some links to videos that people have put up. But in Fame, there's a quote, which is, "Two things make life worth living, love and work. Here at PA, you have the privilege of working hard at something you love." Now, PA is a performing arts school, right? And if we take love as being something exciting, something active, and if we take working as being something quiet and not as obvious happiness, then we have the two there, which we have both excitement and contentment coming from doing art. So if art is so good that it can make you happy in both in a both in a in an excited way and in a really long term way, how could you not let someone do their art? I mean, whether it's singing or acting or sculpting or drawing, or even maths and science can count as an art, because good maths and science is innovative. It's a new way of looking at things, and to do that, you need imagination, and that is exactly what art is. Art is applying imagination to create something. So whenever we create our own art, that is what we are doing. We are making ourselves happy. To be sure, art isn't enough by itself, because we still need, because you couldn't live your whole life just writing beautifully constructed novels. It would suffice, but it would not be a full life. And equally, a full life would not be making YouTube videos your whole life, as I'm sure Everyone on this, and I'm sure people watching this, are not intending to do that. You still need love, and you still need to be happy. You still need to eat well, and you still need friends, and you still need fear from, you know, bungee jumping or skydiving or something like that. But if you have all three, you can take on the world.